Isn't it a beautiful day in September? God is good. What a perfect weekend. Did you get out and enjoy it yesterday? Excellent. I hope you did. If you didn't, you will have this afternoon. I think God's going to give us another great day. We are glad that you're with us today. Thank you for being here. And my name is Brian, and I get to be one of the pastors at Westview. And if you're a visitor or a guest with us today, I want to welcome you. I just want to thank you for being here. We are in for a real treat in terms of the worship service today. Our missions team from Engage Student Ministry is going to be sharing about some of the things that God did in their work over the summer and in their lives. In the midst of that work, we're going to sing songs together. We're going to have a time of rejoicing in the Lord. And after church, if you would like to stay with us, we're going to have an opportunity to enjoy some cuisine from some local food trucks that'll be parked out back. Fellowship Hall is going to be unlocked. We do this every once in a while just to have a time to be together as the church family after worship service. So you're invited to be part of that as well. A couple other announcements at the end, but those can wait until the end. We're here to worship, right? Amen. Amen. If we can minister to you in any way, there's a Connect card in the seat backs in front of you. There's also an app that you can download on your smart device on your phone if you are digitally inclined. We want to know how we can minister to you, so please fill that out. Connect with us so that we can connect with you. Church, let's prepare to worship. Would you stand with me if you are able, please? Let's get our hearts and our minds in the right place to worship our King. Bow with me, please. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your goodness. We thank you for the richness of a relationship with you, for the endearing presence of your Holy Spirit. Throughout the ages, you have been near to your church, and every time they've come together to worship you, Lord, if it's been in spirit and in truth, you have been there in their midst. We thank you for that, Lord. We pray that you are smiling upon us in this day of celebration of all that you've done and all that you're yet doing. God, I pray that you would embolden and invigorate your people today. Let us be passionate about being salt and light in this community. Lord, let us be passionate about showing the love of Christ to our neighbors, to our friends, to our nation, to this world, Lord. Pray, Father, that our lives and the value that you have placed upon our lives, that we would not underappreciate that or undermine that, Lord, that we would see as you see, God. Father, I pray for the needs that may be represented in this room, in individuals and in families. Pray, Father, that those needs would be brought to the foot of the cross. Father, we know that you are able and capable of sustaining your people. You have promised to do so. Lord, we pray that if we could be part of an answer to someone else's prayers today, if we could be your hands and feet, that you would show that even this morning as we're praising you. Father, we pray your blessing and your anointing for all those who will be sharing in the worship service today. I pray, Father, that they would remember that they are in the midst of a family who love them and who are excited for them, and Father, who are joining with them in the work that you've called them to. God, we give you glory today. It's a special day because you made it. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Let's sing together a good old hymn called No, Not One. There's not a friend like the lowly Jesus. No, not one. No, not one. None else could heal all our souls' diseases. No, not one. No, not one. Jesus knows all about our struggles. He will guide till the day is done. There's not a friend like the lowly Jesus. No, not that he would not take him. No, not one. friend like the lonely Jesus. No, not one. No, not one. What a friend we have in Jesus. Amen. Sing with me. Everybody has trials and temptation. Everybody knows heartbreak, isolation. But we can lay our burdens down. We can lay our burdens down. What a friend we have in Jesus. East to west, my sins are gone. I see grace on every horizon. And forever. Everybody has fears, everybody's got worry. Everybody knows sorrow, devastation. But we can lay our burdens down. We can lay our burdens down. What a friend we have in Jesus. East to west, my sins are gone. I see grace on every horizon. And forever and ever, His heart is my home. No more betrayal, for He is faithful. He fills me up and my cup running over. No more betrayal, for He is faithful. How He has proven it over and over. No more betrayal, for He is faithful. He fills me up and my cup running over. No more betrayal, for He is faithful. How He has proven it over and over. Over and over. Oh, what a friend we have in Jesus. East to west, my sins are gone. I see grace on every horizon. And forever and ever, His heart is my home. What a friend we have in Jesus. East to west, my sins are gone. I see grace on every horizon. And forever and ever, His heart is my home. Forever.
Let us pray. Father, we thank You for this promise. We thank You that You are our guide. You are our hope. We place our hope in You, Father. We bring You these offerings and ask that You would place Your blessing upon them, that they may achieve what You desire for Your kingdom. Bless the gifts and the givers in Jesus' holy name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. You may be seated.
Savior loves me so, He will hold me fast. Oh, for my life He bled and died, Christ will hold me fast. Justice has been satisfied.
Be seated. At this time, as the MFuge participants make their way to the stage, we're going to be watching a recap video from their missions week.
Come on.
Yeah.
Come on.
Yeah.
John.
Oh, yeah.
Now, watch out. Right.
You're right.
You got above it. Back for the right.
Yeah, pull this way. Pull it.
Oh, come on. That was
right.
Oh, you're on the real one.
Hope arise and make the darkness hide. My faith is dead, I need a resurrection somehow. I know I'm lost in your freedom. And this world
Well, good morning, church.
That was just a very, very brief recap of what was an incredibly busy and wonderful week back in July. My name is Ethan Kearns. I'm the associate pastor here. I also work with the youth. And one of the things that we did this past summer was go on an MFuge camp experience at Liberty University. And one of the questions I've been getting from different church members is, what exactly is MFuge? What is that, and why are we doing that instead of World Changers? So World Changers, basically at the onset of the pandemic, had to close its doors because of some complications, and they have since been bought out by someone else and reopened. But this year, we had to find an alternative, and we chose a similar Lifeway-backed Southern Baptist-produced event, which is MFuge. And our theme for this year was dwell. And I think that was a very appropriate theme for this year, just about dwelling in the presence of God. And I don't think God could any better have chosen a theme than this one, because after the year that we've been through, we just needed time to dwell in the presence of God. So what we're going to be doing today is going to be interviewing several couldn't be here today, but some of the participants, students and adults, who were able to go on and participate in this MFuge experience over this past summer. So I'm going to go ahead and get right into it. Olivia, I'll start with you. What were some of the things that you were looking forward to or expecting to happen at MFuge?
So one of the things that I was expecting was to be more like World Changers. At World Changers, we do more, I don't want to say hard labor because it's not really that hard, but work that requires you to wear long pants. And so Ethan made sure to tell everyone to bring jeans and long pants because we thought it was going to be like World Changers. Well, it turned out that when we get down to breakfast the first morning, we did not need long pants. No other church was wearing long pants, and so it was going to be like 90 degrees that day. So we're like begging Ethan to go let us change, but he's like, no, we're going to wait and see what the work actually is like. So we get there, and it's just like yard work, and so we didn't really need long pants. But thankfully, after the first day, he did let us wear shorts the rest of the week.
Yes.
So that was good.
Yes.
So we weren't burning up and dying.
Yeah. All right. Sydney, same question for you. What were your expectations or looking forward to?
So honestly, I didn't really have like expectations. I was looking forward to like time away from Martinsburg and just like being able to fellowship like other places than church, like here or at school or like at home. And it was just like fun being able to do it with my friends and stuff. So.
Okay. All right, great. You feel like you needed a break from just being here all the time.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. I hear that. We all kind of feel that. We all feel that, certainly. All right, so Quinn, let me ask you the next question. We went down to Lynchburg, Virginia. Could you describe the city and maybe even the campus of Liberty University, what that was like there?
It was just a really nice setting in general. It's like, it was well laid out. There were great places to walk, and it was just really well maintained and stuff. We went to a really cool coffee shop in Lynchburg.
Oh, yeah, the White Heart Cafe.
Yeah, I had a lavender lemonade. It was pretty good.
It was good, yeah. Good. Lynchburg is a very old city, but it's very beautiful, and the campus of Liberty University. How many of you have been to Liberty's campus before? Yeah? If you've been there 10 years ago, it's very different than it is today. They've since expanded massively. It's huge. Eliana, would you actually be able to share just a little bit about Lynchburg and the campus of Liberty, what you liked about it, what was unique about it, maybe?
There were a lot of different, statues and different sculptures and stuff in the streets and on Liberty campus. And I know a lot of us took different pictures with them, and it was really fun to get to see all those different things, like the giant shoe that we all took a picture in.
Yes.
In Lynchburg.
Yes. We all sat in a big shoe and took a group photo. So, yeah, Lynchburg is a beautiful city. Liberty is a beautiful campus. We're thankful that they were able to host it this year. Next up, I want to talk to Andrew and Bailey. So, Andrew, you can go first. Let me explain something really quick before I ask the question. The day, this experience was split kind of in half. So it's a camp and a missions trip experience, with the first half being one and the second half being the other. So Andrew, why don't you explain what the first half of the day usually looked like for you and for the groups?
So I guess the first half of the day, we would first eat breakfast, of course, and then we would go off to our own mission groups.
Okay.
That we would go into our own room and classroom and talk to each other about our devotion. We had a morning devotion in the morning, and then we got together and we would have little groups and stuff and just talk about how the camp was going and mm-hmm. what we wanted to. And then after, you just go to send off, and then
we go out.
Yeah.
Afterwards. So Bailey, why don't you explain some of that as well? What was the first half of the day looking like for us each day?
We went to breakfast, and they had basically different restaurants, and they had different stuff at each place, and it was really cool. So we ate breakfast. There was like Andrew said, Bible study. Oh my gosh. Bible study groups, and it was split up by grade, and it was really fun and stuff. So we went to those. Oh yeah, we went to morning worship, and that was really cool because it was going to a concert twice a day.
Yeah,
it was very loud, lots of lights, and just it was really cool.
Yeah. Now I actually didn't plan on this, but I want to ask one of the adults what the first half of the day, because it looked a little different. So Brooke, could you answer that?
So to me, when you ask the first half of the day, I mean, I think of the Bible studies as well, but I think of we get to go out into the community and we got to serve. We got to go clean up. I was actually part of a group. The first day we got to pack backpacks for kids that are going to foster care. So their first night away, they are given these backpacks to kind of comfort them. It has necessities in it, and then it also would have a blanket or a pillow or something. Mm-hmm. So when I think of the first half of the day, I think of when we got to go out and serve the community.
So Bailey, actually, I wanted to ask the next question to you anyway. So the service aspect of the day, which was primarily the second half. So what did we do on campus? And Brecken, I'll ask you this question in just a second, but Bailey first.
So the first few days, we were at this foster home, and they had different buildings, and we kind of worked on, it was pretty quick work, so we did a few buildings a day maybe, and then after we were finished with all those, it was yard work and all, pulling weeds, trimming trees, bushes. After that, we went to about the end of the driveway, and they had this little setup area with plants and all, and their sign, and we cleaned that up, and I think it looked really, really nice afterwards. So
this group of students, let me just compliment them really quick. This isn't flattery, I really mean this. You all are incredibly hard workers. If we could have them descend on the campus someday and just clean everything up, this campus would be the most beautiful campus that could possibly exist. But we have an incredibly hardworking group of students, and I'm really thankful to have taken them
specifically. Dennis, you do a great job here, by the way. I'm not trying to slam you. You do a great job. But we have work days every once in a while where we need people, and you guys would be the perfect crew to come. So Brecken, why don't you share a little bit about what the work and the service aspect of the day would look like each day?
Well, to be honest, most of the time I thought I was going to be boiling hot the whole day, but there was a lot of shade.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah, there was sometimes the sun was like beating on your face, but when you went to like under a tree, it felt so nice.
What was the hardest work, Brecken, that you had to do the entire week? The hardest thing?
I didn't do much.
Oh, man, that's good. All right. So, Andrew and Amy, I'll ask you guys this question. Andrew first. There was one evening in the middle of the week that was particularly emotional and impactful and good for all of us. It was called Nightlife. Could you describe what was so special about that one evening specifically?
What was so special about that evening is that we all got to get together and speak to each other about stuff that you wouldn't normally tell other people. Mm-hmm. Like, you could have deep conversations that would stay just in that room and go nowhere else.
Yeah.
So it was a very emotional night because you could actually explain and let out everything that you knew that was very disrespectful and stuff, mistakes that you've made. And when you get to let it out and tell your friends that will comfort you about it, it makes you feel so much better.
Praise God. Absolutely. Amy, what about you?
So our group of ladies had a very similar experience, obviously, but it was... I can't even describe, I don't know what words to really describe how it was. It was very emotional, but we just connected on a deeper level than, you know, we ever thought we really would. Mm-hmm. Each of the ladies and the leaders shared something, like what they were struggling with or, their past experiences. And we just connected on a deeper level, and we shared stories. You know, if one was crying, one on the other side of the circle would come around and, you know, give them hugs and stuff. So it was just so much love that was shared between us. It's something that we would really love to do more often, you know, with the group of ladies, you know, to get together like once every couple months or something, just to keep that deep relationship alive. But it was definitely different than the World Changers. You know, we've had different experiences with that, but the MFuge, we had that opportunity to get together to share with each other, you know, how God has changed, you know, our lives, you know, the walks, the paths that we were on, and just how we have been changed, you know, from, church experiences or, even this trip and stuff. So it was truly amazing. I personally enjoyed it so much. It was what I really needed. So, and I know it was what, you know, these other ladies, you know, really needed as well. So yeah. it was amazing.
So the guys had their conversation. It took about an hour and a half. And to talk to let middle school and high school guys just unload an hour and a half of that is just amazing. It's awesome. And some of you are like, man, that sounds like torture. It's so amazing to be able to get down into the dirt with these gentlemen and grow closer to Christ with them. How long were the ladies out in the middle of the field talking that night?
A long time.
About 3 hours, yeah, I think.
Possibly, yeah, something like that. Yeah, we were out in the campus field area. I don't know, but we were there for a long time. My legs were going numb, but, you know, I still endured it because I really loved it.
Yeah.
So,
yeah, that's wonderful. All right, so I'm going to ask Jackson and I'm going to ask Sydney this question. Jackson first, was there anyone who had a particularly great influence or impact on you while you were there?
Well, I think the pretty standard answer would be Huey.
Huey. Who so, was Huey?
Huey was like our site manager, if okay. that's what I'd call him, at least. He was the, he came from Tennessee just to help out with the MFuge camp and stuff like that. And so he went along with our church, and he did some of the projects that we did. And he introduced us to the Moo Clap, like you saw in the video, where basically if you're standing with your hands on your hips and somebody goes through and claps their hands right through, you have to get down your knees and moo like a cow. So that was interesting, I'll say. But he had such an impact on everybody. He was just this very friendly character. And it didn't strike me until later that he was the human representation of the hands and feet of Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
He was just so intentional about everything that he did, and I thought that was just really inspiring.
Yeah, so I want to stick with you on this for a second. What were some of the intentional things that he did that were impactful for you? Because I think we can learn from this church. I think we can learn from his example.
All right, so one example that comes to mind was he liked cleaning people's glasses. Like just something as simple as that. He had a bunch of wipes in his backpack that he collected by the hundreds just for this ministry. And he'd go around, he'd be like, hey, can I see your glasses really quick? And then he'd clean them right there for you.
And that's awesome.
It's just something small like that. It's the equivalent of washing his disciples' feet.
Yeah, praise the Lord. Sydney, what about you?
Okay, so they mentioned that every morning we had like a Bible study before we went into like worship and out to our work sites. And my Bible study leader, her name was Abby, and she did a really good job of like preparing us for going out to impact the world. Mm-hmm. And I feel like that, like her preparing me before made me more effective, like at the work site. She like made sure that we were positive and that we were ready to go. And I feel like that she did like a really good job of making sure that like she knew where I was and I knew like that I was prepared.
So. Yeah, she really took ownership over caring for you. Yeah, absolutely. Dennis, can I ask you the same question, actually, just off the cuff? You know, who was someone maybe, or maybe some people, who were particularly impactful or influential to you on the trip?
Oh, of course, Amy. As you've seen, you're a whisper in my ear that. The ones that made the most impact on me is just basically our kids.
Mm-hmm.
And you mentioned earlier about the Wednesday night, late night ordeal. And that's the point that struck me the most. Mm-hmm. Of course, when I was asked to go, I'm thinking, you know, these kids don't want no 50-year-old kid or old man going with them. These are kids, you know, what am I going to do for these kids? And that night was probably the most impactful night on me. And if you can just envision, you know, Westview here being four levels of a concert hall at Liberty, and just imagine 1,200 kids, not adults, kids, mm-hmm. young adults, teenagers, middle school, high schoolers, in this arena type thing. And that night, the leaders had each church go out on the wall outside the door on each level, and there was a list of four questions. And one of the questions was asking God for prayer for something. And then each church got called out to go and write something on that paper. And then they come down and we did some worship time, and the leaders took those papers and they put the top probably five or six answers that these kids, teenagers, I keep saying kids, they weren't kids, the young adults, the top probably five answers out of these 1,200 kids. And it made an impact on me, the results that was read off on that. And COVID had a lot to do with it. And the number one, two, three things that these kids wrote, and I'm not just saying our kids, but I'm just saying overall, mm-hmm. 1,200 kids, was anxiety, depression, fear, what these kids were asking prayer for.
Mm-hmm.
And I challenge the congregation to get to know our kids.
Mm.
Do we really know these kids, these young adults? It made an impact on me because as, you know, my kids are growing up and I think, you know, I'm living a good life, I'm enjoying my grandkids. Hey, I don't have to worry about these teens no more. You know, I done served my time in youth and all that kind of stuff. And it made an impact on me thinking, I really need to reconnect with these young adults. They need help.
Yeah, I think sometimes it's easy to look at young adult ministry, student ministry, children's ministry as almost a separate thing to what the real church is.
You may look at a young adult and you may see what they look like on the outside, but what's really going on in the inside is there's a lot of struggle.
Yeah.
And when you are told out of 1,200 kids that the top answers are they're suffering depression, anxiety, emotional of the fear of not even knowing what next week's going to bring, and just the isolation from the last year, that makes an impact.
It does. Absolutely. Absolutely. So, Brecken, I'll ask you a similar question. Is there a story or an experience that sticks out to you as particularly memorable from that past week? Dennis shared about the nightlife. What about for you?
Well, the nightlife was pretty amazing.
Okay.
That was what I was going to say, but, you know.
Do you want to add to that?
Yeah, well, it was, like what you said, it was very emotional.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And there was a very long, kind of annoying wave sound at the beginning of it.
At the, oh,
and it
yeah.
lasted for like 15 minutes.
There was like an audio intro as people were getting ready. Yeah, okay. Yes, that was particularly memorable for you?
Yes.
Like of all the things that happened that week, that sticks out? Okay.
Yep.
I know, yeah. You know what, I want to ask Andrew the same question if you don't mind. What's a particularly memorable experience from that week?
The mega relay.
What was so great about the mega relay? Would you explain it?
I don't know. It was like everyone had their own, like their mission groups. It wasn't your church. It was your mission groups with a bunch of different churches combined together with different people. And I thought it was really cool that people you had no idea who they were, that you would team up and you would go against the other teams and you would, it was a relay. So
yeah,
back and forth. It was.
What were the things that you did in the relay?
Dump soda on you.
Okay. Very youth group thing to do.
What else did we do? We did do where we all, like, you had to, like, make a line by jumping and landing on the ground. Like, wow. And you just kept making a line up. But there was, Brecken got carried.
Okay. Yep. It would sound like a fun time, the Mega Relay, that last night. Tina Lynn lost her backpack, but Tina Lynn's not here, so we won't pick on her too much. So, Eliana, let me ask you this question. After the pandemic, you know, it's been a long 18 months. How was MFuge healing or helpful for you?
I feel like after we were all apart for so long and we didn't see each other, we all sort of broke apart. But during Fuge, we were all stuck together. We were all living in the same building.
Mm-hmm.
We were all together at our work sites and everything, and it brought us closer together, and especially nightlife, with everyone telling each other and trusting each other with their true feelings. It brought us closer together.
Awesome. Praise God. So, Quinn, same question for you also. How was MFuge particularly helpful or healing for you after, or in the midst of, whatever you want to think of it, towards the pandemic?
So during the pandemic, like, I didn't get to hang out with like a lot of different friends. Like, you can call them and text them, but it's not the same. So I got to, like, after the very end of the day, it'd be like 11 o'clock, and we'd had a long day, but we'd still want to hang out and stuff. So Olivia and I would always end up in Sydney and Mallory's room, and pretty sure a bunch of the girls were over there, and we were all talking and hanging out, and it was really fun. So just getting to spend more time with people that you hadn't hung out with for a while.
I was going to say, dare I ask, what was the latest you all stayed up those nights?
Well, I think we got told to go to bed, like, was it like 12:30, 1? Yeah, might have been a little bit earlier than that, but I don't quite remember. It was pretty late.
Yeah, those are what those camps look like. So, Brooke, let me ask you the next question. What was the benefit of being with this particular group of people throughout MFuge? So think about the relationships you formed with students, with the adults. How was that good for you?
So, of course, I went on World Changers, whatever, last time we did. And, of course, my group, we were, like, super bonded. And we were with all different churches, like it wasn't just our church. But what was different and was great about this is because of COVID, for the most part, they kept us with our church group. Mm-hmm. So I actually got to know these guys and girls better because I spent pretty much most of my time with them. Mm-hmm. And I got to just have such deep conversations with them. And mm-hmm. like I have things that I can pray for them, daily.
Yeah.
I just connected with every single one of them.
Yeah.
And even Tina Lynn, I mean, like, she was my girl. But, you know, her and I spent an hour together yeah. looking for a backpack. Mm-hmm. But just being with her and crying with her and, you know, it was amazing.
It's awesome. It's awesome. So I have one last question for, I think, the three seniors who are here. So Jackson, Quinn, and Olivia. So what did you learn about God's goodness throughout this week? So Jackson, why don't we start with you? What did you learn about God's goodness throughout this week?
Well, you're really putting me on the spot here.
Okay. I gave you time to prepare.
I didn't know. Okay. So I'll give you somewhat of like a story. So
okay, that
you
works.
All know Connor Smith. He's been here basically his whole life. Mm-hmm. And he was with us on this trip. And in case you don't know, he's actually there at Liberty University right now. And so how God revealed his goodness to me was I was able to spend my time with him to get a good feel of this is the sort of stuff that he's going to be doing for the next 4 years, right? Mm-hmm. And so I thought it was really good to see God working through his life at Liberty.
Yeah, that's awesome. Kind of prepared you, gave you an idea of what to expect.
Sure.
Because yeah. you're going to graduate soon.
Yeah, pretty soon.
That's crazy. That's crazy. I will say one thing that's interesting about this group, that's unique about this group, is that the seniors that are here, Quinn, Jackson, Olivia, they were the sixth graders when I started here. So they are the last original members of the youth group for me, having started here. So that's just mind-blowing to me. So Quinn, what about you? What did you learn about God's goodness throughout this week?
Well, in the middle of the week, we found out that the staff that was there was not the original staff we were supposed to have because half the staff had gotten COVID. So our week was should have gotten canceled, but the people that came out and were able to run it for us, we got lucky. So it was a reminder that, you know, God did that. He let us still be able to come to Fuge Camp by sending those people.
Yeah, that's right. So several people who had been at other locations or who had been scheduled to work at other sites had to be flown in to Lynchburg because the previous camp crew got, a lot of them got COVID. And it was really complicated. And we could have had that entire week canceled. But because people from all over the country were willing to come serve, we were able to still have it. So we praise God for that, because that was God's providence and God's goodness working through that. Olivia, what about you?
When I think of God's goodness, I think of the worship that happened every mm-hmm. night. It was just so awesome to see, because, yeah, like what Dennis was saying, that there were three different levels to this, like, concert. It was like you're in a concert every night. Mm-hmm. And it was just so awesome to see and to hear. Like, one night, I don't remember which night, but the people that were leading the worship, they, like, all the instruments, they stopped playing, and it was just a cappella. They were just singing, mm-hmm. and you could hear, like, thousands of voices of people lifting up their voices yeah. to sing to God. It was just so amazing to hear and just reminded me of God's goodness.
Yeah. After this pandemic, we've needed to be with a group of people like that, haven't we? Haven't we? That's why we should emphasize so much the regathering of people to be together and to sing together praises to our Lord. So quick question, just by a show of hands. Are we going back to MFuge next year?
Yeah.
Yeah, all right. Praise God. So that's the goal. That's what we would like to do. So we're going to keep praying through that. and seeing what it is that God has opened for us for summer of 2022. I just want to encourage you all as church members, maybe some of you are guests, we do these trips because Jesus has made such a massive impact on our lives. We don't go on these trips just to have fun or even just to hang out, no matter how much that's necessary. We do this to give praise and glory and honor to Jesus Christ and to show the community of Lynchburg and wherever else we go his love so that they may also know that wonderful grace that he gives. So, church, can we give this group a hand for their awesome work that week back in July? And crew, could we actually thank the congregation for sponsoring this trip? Can we just say thank you really quick? One, two, three. Thank you. Thank you all so much for the opportunity to go on this trip. Let me pray, and then I believe we'll have some worship time thereafter, and we'll wrap up. Let's pray. Father, we love you. We thank you so much for this time we got to spend together, to go out into the city of Lynchburg, to be able to share the gospel with people, and in more cases, to actually, for us, to grow closer to you. I pray that we would never forget this week, that the excitement and the energy behind it all would not fade, but that we would take what we learned and take what we came to know about you, and let that be a catalyst for us to go out into our own community. And perhaps for some of those who are going to be moving on to college in the years to come, that they would be motivated to go out and to share the love of God to the nations, unreached people groups, and others. That this church would be an incubator for missionally minded teens and young adults to go out and share the gospel. For your name, we pray. Amen. Everybody, you can go ahead and sit down. We'll turn it over to Pastor Jason.
Amen. Can I tell you guys a story? So yesterday, I was here getting stuff ready, like part of my job, and I go home, and my wife is watching The Great British Baking Show. Anybody know what I'm talking about, The Great British Baking Show? Yeah. And she said, it's so interesting because there's so many different types of people from so many different places. And she said, is that the way, like, England is? And I said, well, yeah, it kind of is. Everybody doesn't look the same. Everybody's not from this exact same spot. And I think we lose sight of that sometimes here in the hills of Martinsburg, West Virginia, where a lot of people look like us. But in heaven, there's going to be people of all languages, of all nations, and they're all joined together worshiping the one who reigns. And I want to experience a little bit of that. I can't wait till we get to heaven to see that. But we can have that here and now as well. Let's stand together and sing He Reigns.
It's the song of the redeemed, rising from the ash. Song of the forgiven, drowning out the Amazon rain. The song of patient believers, filled with God's holy fire. It's every tribe, every tongue, every nation, a love song born of a grateful choir. It's all God's children singing glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah, He reigns, He reigns. Let it rise above the four winds, caught up in the heavens. and all the powers of darkness tremble at what they just heard. 'Cause all the powers of darkness can't drown out a single word. When all our children sing out glory, glory, hallelujah, He reigns, He reigns. All our children sing out glory, glory, hallelujah, He reigns, He reigns. All our children sing out glory.
Church, God's word says in Psalm 91, He who dwells in the shelter of the Most High will abide in the shadow of the Almighty. I will say to the Lord, my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust. That is the truth that we should be abiding in. The first verse is a truth, is a statement of truth. The second verse is a response. Every time we come into this place to worship should be a response to what God is revealing about Himself and revealing about us in this world and our mission in this world. You do not have to go on a mission trip somewhere else to dwell in the stronghold and to the abode of the Most High. It's not a place, it's actually Jesus that's being talked about. It's God who's being talked about in that verse. And my challenge to you this morning, as you've heard testimony from these mission trip participants, these students who went to the mountaintop, because that's how it feels to go on a mission trip, to be on a mountaintop experience. But then you come home and you have to decide how you're going to live the next day and the next day, where you're going to dwell. Where are you dwelling right now, church? Are you dwelling in the peace of His presence? Are you dwelling in the unity of Christian brotherhood and sisterhood? Are you dwelling in the purpose that He has for your life? If you're not walking with Him, I want you to know that He's there waiting to take your hand if you would reach out to Him. Church, we are blessed in so many ways to be able to even worship in the freedom that we've experienced this morning, to sing these songs of praise knowing that they're being heard by our Creator. Don't ever forget that. Don't ever lose sight of that. I would guess that a lot of people have experienced many of the things that these students bravely talked about, that they've been going through over the last 2 years. We need not go through those experiences alone and suffer in silence. That's why God gave us community, Christian community. That's why God gave us His Holy Spirit. When we're born again, the Spirit comes and lives within us. So if you cannot claim the promise of that scripture that I read this morning, I would challenge you as we close this worship service, as I'm even praying God's blessing upon us as we go, that you would reach out to Him and ask Him to give you not only salvation in Christ, first and foremost, to give you new life in Him. Because you can dwell in a place of security and peace, regardless of what this world is doing and throwing at us. Amen? You're not alone, church. We have one another. We have our Lord. These are great days to be alive. I pray that there are many more mission trips and many more testimonies to be shared, because the best is yet to come. Let me pray over us, and I'll give you a couple announcements. Father, I thank you so much for the courage that was exhibited on this chancel this morning by these adults and students who brought testimony of all that you did in their lives. Lord, I pray for the days ahead, that the work of ministry, evangelism, outreach, discipleship, community, all of those things that we cherish and that we need in this world, that they would continue at Westview Baptist Church. Father, we pray as we leave this service this morning that you would go before us, that you would launch us into your will for this day. God, we know that you have a plan and a purpose in it, and we ask, Lord, that you would make us aware of it and give us the courage to receive it. In Jesus' name, amen. Church, before I dismiss you, just one or two quick things. Again, you're invited to stay and participate in the fellowship, food truck fellowship, if you'd like to. There is a sign-up sheet, just two things, I promise. There's a sign-up sheet outside in the foyer that has a slot for each month, November, December, January, February, each month, where we're asking a Sunday school class to sign up for our third week fellowship meal each week on Wednesday night. If you don't know this, every Wednesday we have a meal in the fellowship hall at 5:30. to get you fed and ready to go into Bible study time and groups and everything else. A couple of classes have signed up. There's still some more slots open. If your class isn't on there, please pray about being part of that. And also, one last thing. One of the events that we look forward to in the fall is the Trunk or Treat. The Trunk or Treat Halloween this year. We don't, listen, the holiday isn't what it's about to us. Halloween happens to be on October 31st on a Sunday this year. It's not about the holiday that we're celebrating. We as a church are doing this Trunk or Treat like we do every year because thousands of people in this community are going to be walking by this church anyway, and we want them to come on the campus and interact with their neighbors, to just love on them, to minister to them. So if you look in the bulletin, we have some information about there in there about signing up. We have enough committed people to set up, so we're thankful for that. Now we're in the piling up candy stage of preparation, so please do that. Some people have asked about, they have some friends that want to come and set up a trunk, or they, if you have a friend or a family member that wants to come and set up with you as a member of this church, you can do that. That's okay. All right. What we are trying to be careful of is just anybody from the community coming in and setting up and maybe not representing what we want to represent as we do this. So there are some guidelines in the bulletin. If you have questions, see the staff. But this is a great outreach event for us. It really is. It's right here on the campus. So be praying that God would just send them in droves down this street so we can connect with them and even pray and encourage. Okay, church? That's it for announcements. Come back tonight. We got a lot going on. Thank you for being here today. God bless.